Hi children, it is such a pleasure to be with you once again. We will be doing today our fifth lesson on the community of believers. Before we do that, let us do a short revision of the first four lessons. This will help you to understand today's lesson better. Okay, could you tell me the title of the first lesson? Yes, you are right. It is on the ascension of Jesus in heaven. After God the Father raised Jesus from the dead, he appeared to his apostles and disciples 13 times for 40 days. On the 40th day, Jesus was taken to heaven. Before going to heaven, he gave his apostles a mission to do, a job to do. And what was that job? It was to go out to the whole world and to preach the good news about Jesus to the whole world. Now, tell me, what could be the title of the second lesson? It is the first Pentecost day in Jerusalem. On the 50th day, the 11 apostles, along with Mary, the mother of God, were gathered together in one place. When they were praying, a sound from heaven came like the rush of a mighty wind, and tongues of fire rested on the apostles' head, and they were filled with the Holy Spirit, and they began to speak in foreign languages, and the Holy Spirit gave them the courage to go out and preach the good news. On the first day itself, Peter baptized 3,000 people who believed in Lord Jesus. Now, who is the Holy Spirit? He is the third person of God in the Trinity. Now, tell me, what is the title of the third lesson? Can you recollect the title? It is The Lame Man Walks. When Peter and John were going up to temple to pray, a man who was lame from birth was begging there, asking Peter for some money. Peter did a wonderful thing. In the name of Jesus, Peter healed his legs, and the lame man began to jump and praise God. The Jewish high priest were very angry with Peter and John because they had healed the lame man in the name of Jesus and were preaching about Jesus boldly. Hence, they arrested them, put them in the prison. And this is the title of our fourth lesson. Peter and John are arrested and set free. The high priest set free Peter and John, but only after giving them a warning not to speak about Jesus again. But Peter, filled with the Holy Spirit, replied that he would only listen to God and not to them. Peter and apostles then went out and continued to preach the good news about Jesus with courage and enthusiasm, and the number of believers grew largely. Okay, before we start on the fifth lesson, let's play a game of chalks and flats. I am going to give you four situations. You tell me how the people who stay in chalks will deal with the situation, and how the people living in flats will deal with the same situation. Okay, here I go. First situation. Mary's parents drop her to school, and her grandmother is alone at home. She is not well and needs help. You decide the solution as to where she could get help immediately, whether in a chawl or a flat. You put a tick. Where you feel. Second situation, you have missed the school and you need to copy notes urgently. Where do you think you will get to copy the notes quickly? If you are in a chore or you are in a flat, you put a tick. Third situation, you have a wedding in your family and relatives from another city have come to your house and you need to find a temporary place for them to stay. Where do you think you will get a place to stay immediately, in a chore or in a flat? Put a tick. Fourth situation, you want to watch the World Cricket Finals, which will be telecast at 2 in the afternoon, and the elders of your house want to rest for the afternoon and they do not want to be disturbed. Where do you think you can make arrangements to watch the finals? In a chawl or in a flat? Put a tick. In chawls, families and children live close to each other. Hence, there is more bonding, joy, sharing, togetherness amongst them. Children can move in and out quickly. They can gather together. They can assemble quickly, call out to one another, plan, play, seek help immediately. Children in flats take time together to get the children together, as there are few flats on a single floor and you have to climb stairs or take a lift to call out to your friends to play or to get help. The early Christian community who lived together in love and fellowship were always bonding with one another, sharing with one another. They shared their food, their possessions, they supported one another, and they lived close to one another. Now we move to our lesson on the community of believers. The apostles Peter, John and others were filled with the Holy Spirit. Now who is the Holy Spirit? He is the third person of one God in the Holy Trinity. The Holy Spirit gave the apostles the courage to speak about how Jesus was crucified by the Jews and how God the Father had raised Jesus from the dead. And they asked the people to repent, to say sorry, and to believe in Jesus Christ. The apostles also worked many miracles in the name of Jesus. People were amazed as to how Peter, a fisherman, could speak so well and was so full of knowledge. They also began to wonder how Peter and the apostles could heal the sick. Peter explained to them that they could work miracles only in the name of Jesus. It was Jesus who gave them power to do his work. Therefore, more and more people began to believe in Jesus and were baptized. The number of believers began to grow and they began to pray and care for each other. They welcomed all who were baptized in the community and treated one another as brothers and sisters. They met together in the temples or in their homes to pray and were known as praying communities. The people sang psalms, praising and thanking God with one heart and soul. Psalms are songs of praise. Even Jesus used to sing the psalms. The early Christians then began to worship Jesus as their Lord and Savior and came to be known as the worshiping community. They gathered together in their homes to break bread. Breaking bread means Holy Eucharist or Holy Communion. They first read passages from their holy books, before breaking of bread. It is just like a mass. On Sunday, we all come together for mass. In the first part of the mass, we listen to the word of God, that is two readings and a gospel. In the second part of the mass, the priest breaks the big host and distributes the small host to the people. In both the parts of the mass, the people worship Jesus as their Lord and Savior. The early Christians were also known as serving community, as they shared their food and possessions with each other. They did not say, "This is mine, that is yours." They said, "Let's share our food and our homes." Everything was put in common use. They ate, they drank what each one brought with glad and generous hearts. People who owned lands or many houses sold it and gave the money to the apostles, who then gave it to the needy. They saw to it that no one was in need. There was a believer by name of Joseph who sold his field and gave the money to the apostles. The apostles gave him a new name, Barnabas, which means son who encourages. Because Barnabas encouraged others to be more loving and more generous to the brothers and sisters in Christ. Seeing this, more and more people joined the community of believers, and their numbers increased tremendously. Children, we have been talking about early Christians. This is around 2000 years ago. Now, coming to our present times, we too belong to small Christian communities. You have one in your area. You must be knowing what these small Christian communities do. They pray the rosary, they pray the way of the cross, they have an area mass. Some of the Christian communities organize area mass. They have the Christmas party, a visit to the orphanages, to the clergy homes, etc. Some of the members of these small Christian communities go out of their way to help their neighbors or someone in need. These people are living witnesses to our Christian faith. What can you do? Even a small action like giving a cup of tea to an old woman or greeting your friends on the street, you give witness to our Christian faith. Greeting a Hindu or a Muslim neighbor, sharing sweets for Diwali, Eid, etc. helps you to be like Jesus on earth. We children can do no great things, but we can do only small things with great love. Small Christian communities have continued the work of Jesus even when our churches were closed on account of coronavirus. They helped. The members went out of their way to help the needy people in their area. They put into action Jesus' commandment to love your neighbor as yourself. Children, you can now see the picture of a Jewish home made of stones on the screen, and it has a big garden which offers shade and where you can sit for prayer service in the afternoon. Now imagine that you are sitting there when Peter, John, James enter with a new group of believers who have received baptism just yesterday. All the people, including yourself, stand up to welcome them. The apostles then greet everyone by their names. And then Peter introduces the new group of believers into the community. All the people then greet the new group, saying, "Peace be with you." Now sit on the green grass and listen to the word of God being read from the book of the Acts of the Apostles.
A reading from the books of the Acts of the Apostles, chapter 2, verse 36, and chapter 4, verse 11. All the people of Israel then are to know for sure that this Jesus, whom you crucified, is the one that God has made Lord and Messiah. Jesus is the one of whom the scripture says, "The stone that you, the builders, despised, turned out to be the most important of all." The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Above passage meant that Jesus, who was crucified and rejected by the people of Israel, is now our Lord and our Savior. He is the cornerstone. Cornerstone means the main stone, the main pillar, the foundation of our church and our lives. The early Christians, they sang songs. Now let us also sing the song. We will take the song, "The Lord is my light and my salvation." Conclude, I have a small homework for you. It is put up on the screen. Do it and send it to me.
It's a quiz. A. How many small Christian communities are there in our parish? B. The area number, the area name, and the zone number of the small Christian community you belong to. C. The name of the coordinator, animator of your area. D. The number of families in your area. E. Think of some ways in which you could be of help to your community. You have an option. You could record a video of yourself doing the action song, it's I who build the community. You can take assistance from your brother or sister or parents and send the video back to me.
Now let's do the action song. It's I who build a community.
It's me who builds community. It's me who builds community. It's me who builds community. It's me who builds community. La la la. Roll over the ocean, roll over the sea, roll over the ocean in the deep blue sea. Roll over the ocean, roll over the sea. Go and do your part and build community. It's you who builds 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 community. La la la. Roll over the ocean.
Send it to me. Okay, now children, bye for now. God be with you and your parents, and God bless you. Till we meet again.